This is Mike Shore, and this is a tutorial on using Flowgorithm for our last assignment in Lesson 9. I just wanted to make this available to you so you could look at how I approach this if I were doing the assignment, and maybe help you iron out some things in Flowgorithm. And again, Flowgorithm is just a way of creating a flowchart that can also be used to test your chosen environment and solution to the problem at hand. And again, programming is all about solving problems. It's not showing off your mastery of a specific programming language or anything like that. Always remember, programming is about solving problems. So we're going to start off with step 3 of this assignment, because I am assuming at this point that you have obtained and installed Flowgorithm. So here's the first thing we need to do according to step 3, and that is to add our name and class in a comment box. And again, there's not an add button as the instructions talk about, but what you're going to do is just click on the connectors, which are these little lines that run between the different operating blocks. Again, all programs in the flow chart should be prefaced with a main button or a main shape here and an end shape, indicating that that's the beginning and end of the program. So the first thing we're asked to do in step 4 is to create some variables. So I'm going to go ahead and declare some integers for our program. And all you did, again, is just click on the connector and double click on the shape. So that's that. That's step 4. We need to now do step 5. And what we're doing here is getting input from the user. But before each input, we need to create an output. So I'm going to go back, create a shape, output, double click. And again, this is a string, so we want to put double quotes around it. It doesn't have to be anything too fancy for this type of example. And I need to put an input, and that's going to be num1, another output, input the second number. Now I need to actually create a result from those two numbers. So I'm going to use an assign button or assign shape. And we're going to give that answer to the variable result. And I'm just going to do a simple addition. And now I just need to do step 7, which is to output the results. And to add multiple items in our output string, I just need to use the ampersand. And then result. And that should function properly. So let's test it out. Two plus two should equal four. So our simple addition program works fine. Now there's a couple other things you need to do. You need to create some test cases, and that's just simply going back up here, and I'm going to do it right there. Create a comment. Let's do test cases 2 plus 2 equals 4. So that's all you have to do for that. And I hope this has helped you get past some of the hurdles that I have heard about in using Flowgorithm. As usual, I want to caution you, whenever you see a new updated version of software, it may not be exactly like the instructions given to you for an assignment. But please, don't let that bother you. Just press forward. Be bold. As my professors at Texas used to say, be bold. Be an engineer. In this case, be a programmer. Until next time, take care. And good luck with your studies.